first and 10. Converts it to the rookie from North Carolina, Ryan Switzer. And he takes this one just shy of midfield all the way to the 49. That one goes for 22 yards.
Never make the mistake that the slot receivers, especially the little guys like we're watching here, are just quicker than fast. A lot of them combine quickness and speed, and they catch a lot of footballs, as we just saw there.
So they're still at the original line of scrimmage here. Second down and 10. Here's the first carry now for Todd Gurley. And he tried to bounce it outside, but they'll stop him behind the line. They lost two there, and it's third down.
I think there's one element that just keeps increasing on defense in the NFL, and that's speed. They wanted it every position. We just saw there, to linebackers who go sideline to sideline, run past that trash, go past people, and make tackles near the sidelines.
Not only near the sideline, but also in the backfield there for the Rams.
If you're in the linebacker spot and you're seeing this play develop, he heads out towards the flat first, and it often gets you to overcommit running in that direction. Then he cuts back up inside you into the middle of the field. That's what we just saw there for a nice pickup.
Time running out here on the play clock. Set him back five.
Still first down.
Over.
looking to throw. Block. Austin's got it left side. And he'll be taken down at the 46-yard line. 5 yards on the catch. Brings up second down. Still left on second down.
Here we go now. Blue 90. Blue 90.
They'll run it now. Out of going. And they went the wrong way there. Losing yardage back at the 43-yard line. So he loses 3 yards there. Now third down. We've become so accustomed to it, you sort of take it for granted.
You really do, but he is so good that every team in his division, every year, is trying to make sure they draft people charged with trying to block J.J. Watt. So far,
right,
hasn't been too Blue successful.
Landed. Blue 90! All right, now, lucky 56! Lucky 56! Gone, gone! Gone, gone! Watch it now, Barney!
The play clock's running down. They just do get the playoff as he'll look to throw. Looking right side, and it's complete to Watkins. And he'll get it into enemy territory just across midfield at the 49. It'll be a gain of eight, but it'll also lead to a fourth down.
They didn't get the first down, but I have to say, I do like the call. I like what they were trying to do. Try and hit your receiver on the run and see if he can pick it up. Keep it on his feet, get a little rack yardage.
Yeah, but a nice job defensively to get to him and keep him short of the first. On is the punter, Hecker, as he gets this one away. It's just a 30-yard punt that time, no return. And the Texans are going to have the football with a first and 10 deep in their own territory.
Fast, quick, and in a hurry. Suddenly, he was there.
In a blink of an eye, that happened fast and a big sack. On second down, here's Watson. And the hit jarred loose. It's incomplete.
That would have been a great catch, but it's really difficult to hold on to it because it was contested all the way. Would have been a great play if he'd been able to haul that one in.
And on third down, a nickel formation here defensively. Touchdowns here in the first half. This becomes a pretty important drive, doesn't it?
It certainly does, and a lot of the teams script plays. We know that, right? They have a script to start the ball game, and typically those scripts go between 12 and 24, 25 plays. Down two touchdowns early, probably not very deep into their script. I think they're going to stay with it. I don't think they'll abandon it just yet and try and generate some offense on this drive.
Anything, at least 3 points, get that zero off the board.
Now that's staying ahead of the chains. Really good pickup on first down, hitting the tight end there. That brings up a second and manageable.
Just found a hole in that zone. Blitzed. A nice job picking that up, completing the pass.
And how in sync was the quarterback in his center on that play? They saw the blitz, made the appropriate calls, got the line engaged, because now they know there are going to be extra guys coming at the quarterback, so they got their assignments down pat and kept them away from him, and he's able to step up in the pocket and fire one now for a really good strike.
And he's going to get this inside the 30. Another nice gain, 16 yards there, and a first down again.
Nice job, nice patience right there. Put him on the right side, let him work his way across, put the ball in his hands, and let him work his way upfield with a catch. Quite a surprise to a guy playing defense, because not ordinarily thought as a pass catcher, it often works when they decide to dial it up. Precise as routes are supposed to be run in the NFL, maybe they're not quite as precise in college ball.
That's accurate, yeah.
And I think we saw a college route in the NFL there. Just find the soft spot, find the dead zone, and find the first down. And that's what he just did.
2 minutes to play here in the first half. We're back to Houston after this timeout. A reminder coming up at this and every halftime this season, we'll be checking in with Larry Ridley in Orlando for highlights and analysis of our first half.
That's my man.
And he'll get into the end zone. Touchdown, Rams. Todd Gurley taking it in from 11 yards out. And the Rams are able to get back within a touchdown. Solid job up front, really just a solid job all the way around to get that one in.
That was well executed, wasn't it? Well blocked, well run, end result, 6 points.
Touchdown. So that drives 7 plays in length, and it's finished off by a Todd Gurley touchdown run. The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. This fielded a few yards into the end zone. Well, some might have returned that one. He won't. He'll go down to a knee, and they'll start the drive from the 25. And the Texans set to come onto the field. They're starting to put some space here. The first quarter, they didn't look so hot offensively. This second quarter, though, they looked really good.
They jumped in the saddle in a big way now, and now they're in full gallop. I mean, before, kind of cantering around a little bit, right, trying to feel their way, not getting done what they wanted to. But somehow they put it together with play calling, execution, and now it's a pretty big gap.
And they look to make that gap even bigger here. He finds an opening past the 40. Completes it to Powell. 16 yards on that one, and also attacks it first down. And a good quarterback facing zone coverage. If he has just a little bit of time to survey the scene, that's what's going to happen.
No doubt about it. If there's no pressure, he's going to continue to pick them apart because he'll have all that time to find someone open downfield. He can only cover for so long. So maybe they want to go to a zone blitz scheme. Get a little bit more pressure. Remember when Carolina did that against Denver? They lost the game ultimately. They dropped the defensive end out, and he ended up with an interception in that game in Super Bowl 50. Maybe some sort of scheme like that to try and get more pressure at the passer.
It's a gain of 6, moves him to a manageable 3rd-and-2 situation.
I thought that was a good call. Passing situation on 2nd down, they hit him with a draw instead and pick up nice yardage.
Yeah, because the draw, they're thinking pass when they see that initially defensively, right?
Well, you know, in today's NFL, most of the time on 2nd and long, when it's a passing situation, pass rushers are on the field and they're only thinking one thing, get to the quarterback. Half the time you can bypass him with a running play.
Here's Watson. Stop it with just over a minute to go before halftime. The kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. This one taken from the 7. And it'll take this one near the 25, call it the 26-yard line. Now we see Sammy Watkins getting ready to go again on offense. They've got to be thinking, how can we get him a little bit more involved here? 2nd quarter, you're down, and really, he's been out of the mix.
I would agree with that, and oftentimes you hear, well, we're just taking what the defense is giving us, but sometimes that's just not good enough. Sometimes you have to take what you want, and that means getting him the football.
Yeah, so far just a single catch in this game. Throwing to start the drive. Brock. The right side is into the hands of his tight end, Everett. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. Now whistles come. They'll stop it with just over 40 seconds to go in the first half. So the defense has put them in a tough spot. It's 2nd and long. They're down to one remaining. Need something from deep in the bag of tricks here after first and second down went backwards. It's third and very long. This fourth and long, and they're gonna go for it.
Hurry up, here we go. Blue landing. Blue landing.
Leopard. Leopard.
Gone, gone. Gone, gone. Over, over. Over, over. All right, now, lucky 56. Lucky 56.
They'll try and throw for it here. Surprising move to go for it. Predictably, somewhat predictably, it doesn't pay off. And the Texans take over an excellent field position. But Carter, I'm not really sure what in the world they were thinking on fourth and long there at this stage in the game, but do you think social media may be firing up a little bit right now?
The coach is trending right now. All right, there's no doubt about it. People are wondering what that decision was. But it takes me back to a number of years ago. A very successful coach in the league had told himself before a playoff game, he's going to be aggressive. No matter what, he's going to be aggressive. And he ran his team into some real problems early, and they got upset in that playoff game. Let's see if this team can recover.
Well, that's aggressive in capital letters with glitter, seven underscored. I mean, that's the definition of aggressive.
Yeah, you can almost hear the cheerleaders doing the be aggressive chant behind him, and he listened to it.
Now the Texans are going to call on the field goal unit. From the left hash, this from 34. And his kick here is good. And that will extend their lead even further. It's a little bit of time left here in the second quarter, but they get the field goal near the end of the first half to expand that lead.
Now that's got to feel good, but they can't let up. Now on the kickoff, they've got to make sure they don't give up a big return. To set up the other team for one last chance to score themselves.
And a good effort on the return there. Gets them across the 30 to the 33-yard line.
Here in the first half. They come after him. They've sat back. I think that's what you need to do to keep an offense guessing.
And they certainly have kept him on their toes. That's why they haven't had much success on the scoreboard.
No. Check. Patriot.
The final shot before break. Block. And just shedding him off there. A battle for it here, and this will be caught.
Personal foul. Face mask. Defense.
So they'll take the yardage and tack on 15 more for the face mask.
Talk about play that actually costs you in the end. Just trying to do your job, right? Trying to get him on the ground. Next thing you know, they'll march up another 15 against your squad.
Save the replay highlights and apparently get right back to the action here in the third. teams appear ready for the fight ahead, and we resume action here in quarter number three. This fielded a few yards into the end zone. And a good return as he'll be stopped just shy of the 30-yard line. The Texans offense now, they get set to head back onto the field. This is sort of what you would call a put-away drive, isn't it? They score here, especially a touchdown. It's almost out of reach.
It certainly feels that way, and I think that they're going to call their plays accordingly, because what you really want to do, even though you know the scoreboard is still up there and the game's going to go on, but you take the spirit away from another team. If they drive and will to come back and win, can be taken with another score right here.
Still third quarter, but you just get that feel.
Yeah, the teeter right there on the brink, aren't they? There will always be a place for methodically marching the ball downfield, but when you can pick it up in big chunks and strike like that, have explosive plays, that's often the difference in winning and losing. Those types of plays that can knock a defense off balance, that'll drop the team.
Touchdown, Houston. A great play there. And the second touchdown here in this opening weekend. And the Texans turn that interception into a touchdown. Getting your back involved, what's the importance there in the passing game?
Oftentimes you can create mismatches because who's going to cover, and you get him into space, which is what he likes to operate with the ball in his hands. Oftentimes makes people miss because that run after the catch, and off he goes.
Into the end zone. This is fielded at the goal line. He's able to get it across the 20, but not by much, as he's marked down at the 21 yard line. The attention turns back to the Rams offense as they get ready for their first possession of the second half. They trail offense, first time to touch the ball in quarter three, and we'll see what they can do.
And I can't wait to see what they have planned, because some teams script to start a half, other teams just go, okay, these are the sequence of plays we want to run, these things worked well for us, but sometimes they throw in that big chunk play right away.
Shocker.
Try and get after them early and try and create a big play to give themselves some momentum.
See what they have up their sleeve. Looking to throw on second down. And he's going to be intercepted a third time. Picked off by the 41. And a half possession. And they have it at the 38-yard line.
So that's back-to-back drives with a... Thank you.